Black TV 24/7 News for the latest information relating to the Black experience. I'm Erin Elkins, and here are today's headlines. Our top story, 7 murders in less than 70 hours from 10 different shootings rocked several Baltimore neighborhoods over the holiday weekend. Police have beefed up patrols, flooding several city blocks after fear set in across Baltimore City as the already besieged city's murder rate escalated in a matter of hours.
We will be having a very heavy police presence in the city, proactive patrols. We're going to be doing some roll call on the streets as opposed to districts.
The first murder happened just a half hour before midnight Saturday. Then one murder followed every 9.5 hours, putting neighborhoods on edge and stretching a strained police force to the brink. But authorities are certain they have it under control.
We're still considerably down in homicides, but to see this eruption is a little frustrating, certainly.
So far, there have been 78 people killed in Baltimore this year. 94 were murdered this time last year. And now on the international front, Blantyre. Malawi's president has pardoned a gay couple sentenced to 14 years in prison, ordering their immediate release, but insisted that homosexuality was still illegal in his conservative Southern African nation. President Biku Wa Mutharika announced the pardon on humanitarian grounds only during a press conference with UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon. The release comes as Malawi faced international condemnation for the conviction and harsh sentencing of Tuwangi Chimbilanga and Stephen Monjeza, who were arrested in December, a day after celebrating their engagement. Ban praised Mutharika's decision, but said laws that criminalize sexuality should be repealed. In Washington, the Obama administration also praised the move, urging an end to the persecution and criminalization of sexual orientation and gender identity. Activists welcomed the presidential pardon and hoped it would help their efforts to overturn Malawi's anti-gay laws and attitudes. Malawi is among 37 African countries with anti-gay laws. And that's a look on the international front. And now, sports and entertainment. Former Temptations frontman Ali Ali Woodson has died after a long battle with leukemia. The Detroit native was the lead singer of the legendary Motown group from 1984 to 1986, and again from 1988 to 1996. Woodson also wrote and performed lead vocals on the group's hit single, Treat Her Like a Lady. Woodson left the Temptations in 1996 and began performing as a solo artist. In the 70s, Woodson performed with the Drifters and later replaced Teddy Pendergrass in the group The Blue Notes. Ollie Woodson, gone at 58. And that's a wrap for sports and entertainment. And now, on this day in Black history, noted preacher, abolitionist, and women's rights activist Isabella Bomfrey changed her name to Sojourner Truth, vowing to stand against slavery wherever she encountered it. Truth would spend the next 40 years risking her life in favor of abolition, speaking against gender inequity, and campaigning for the federal government to provide freed slaves with land in the New West. This former slave would inspire a nation and encourage a race, and her journey for truth began on this day in 1843. Well, that's it for us here at Black TV 24/7 News. For more information on the stories covered during this newscast, please visit us at BlackTV247News.com and click on the story links. Until Wednesday, I'm Erin Elkins. Have an encouraging day. And remember, you can catch us online 24/7.